In this video, we explain the direct monitoring feature on Volt interfaces. Why do you need direct monitoring? Direct monitoring on Volt makes sure that you always hear your input signals with no delay in your headphones and monitors. When using your audio software's monitoring feature, input signals from Volt will pass through the software before being heard from Volt's monitor or headphone outputs. Because the signal is passing through the software, it uses the software's buffer, which causes latency. Latency means the signal is delayed, with the amount of delay depending on the buffer size. Higher buffer sizes will cause higher amounts of delay, which can make recording more challenging. The buffer size can be lowered to reduce the amount of latency, however, this will make your computer's CPU work harder and may cause pops, clicks, or other audio artifacts. You will have to experiment with the buffer size until you achieve a setting that allows low latency recording, yet doesn't cause clicks or pops. Volt's direct monitoring allows you to listen to the input signals directly from Volt without latency, because the signal doesn't pass through the audio software first. If you want to record while monitoring through an effect in your software, then you can use your software's input monitoring feature instead of using Volt's direct monitoring. For example, you may want to record a vocal with a bit of reverb by using your software's input monitoring feature to listen to the input signal through a reverb plugin as you record. In this scenario, disable direct monitoring on Volt and enable input monitoring in your recording software. You will hear more or less latency depending on the buffer size and plugins used. Make sure to only enable either software monitoring or direct monitoring. If both are active at the same time, you will hear a phasing or doubled effect depending on the amount of latency. For the lowest latency possible while recording, use Volt's direct monitoring feature. On Volt 1 and Volt 176, simply press the direct button to hear your input signal through the monitor and headphone outputs. On Volt 2 and Volt 276, press the direct button once to activate stereo input monitoring. The direct LED turns orange. You will now hear the signal from input 1 on the left and the signal from 2 on the right. Use this setting when you have a stereo source like a keyboard connected. By pressing the direct button again, mono input monitoring is activated and the direct LED turns blue. You will now hear both input signals centered. Use this setting when you have mono sources connected, such as a guitar and/or a microphone. Volt 476 features four monitor source buttons that allow you to select which sources are directly heard through the monitor and headphone outputs. The available options are inputs 1 and 2, inputs 3 and 4, outputs 1 and 2, and outputs 3 and 4. Out 1 and 2 is selected by default so that computer playback sent to the output channels 1 and 2 is heard. Multiple sources can be selected and monitored at the same time. Press the buttons for the inputs or outputs that you want to hear through the monitor and headphone outputs. By default, direct monitoring on Volt 476 is set to stereo. To monitor input sources in mono, press the mono button. Note that the volume of system playback is reduced by 5 dB when direct input monitoring is enabled, so you can clearly hear your input signals while recording. Make sure to disable direct input monitoring when you're finished recording to hear system playback at the normal level.